Hi guys, and welcome to another video. So today we are, well, we've just jumped back. It is 9 o'clock. We've just come back for some breakfast quickly. So we're gonna jump in the thingy. The gator. Well, not actually, we're not jumping in the gator. What are we jumping in? We're jumping the pickup. No. We'll do what we were planning to do. So we've got some, well, we've had some new toys given to us. So the plows need to be sorted. They're going to the pig farm, which we now own. There's quite a lot of stuff that will be moved off this farm. Like them. All of them will be moved. We've got a lorry, and we're going to buy a low loader. We're just going to put them all on and then send them up. Main stuff will be like the balers, the thingy that's staying, the trailers here, they're staying, the dung spreaders, the slurry spreaders are staying on this farm. Where have I come down here? Oh, I know why. So I'm just wondering, I was looking for the meal. So we've brought a yard scraper for the old Mass Ferguson. So this is now our yard scraper. It scrapes all the manure out of this over to that grass, little grass bit over straight and forward, and then we have the telehandler that will come and scoop it up and moves it from one pile to then the big pile, which we can go and have a look at right now. So the big pile at the moment is this. The cows, this is after 3 days. The cows have been producing a lot of dung, and we've had brought some dung in as well. But yeah, this is a lot of dung for us. The lorries have been out. The milk tanker has been out to drop a load of milk off for them. There you go. Just giving them some fresh water. So our parlour, this is our parlour. We don't do much in this parlour because workers are in here. So we're not really involved in that type of parlour work. But we are going to be spreading some slurry. So I've left the gator up there because we don't really need it. Got a couple of fields to get done today. We're going to spread some slurry today. So this is another new machine, well, piece of equipment we've brought, a 2,500 gallon tanker. We've purchased it because we were going to, well, this is the contractor's, ours is coming soon. We're going to get a little major one, so that we can do a bit of slurry work. We're not using the contractor the contractor's tanker. We've got a tanker for the farm, and then we've got a tanker for the contractors. So that we can do, like, we're not, if we need to spread some slurry, we can spread. So I think this has already had some slurry put on it. I think this has already had some slurry put on it because it's only doing a little bit. So yeah, we'll. This will be the same. You always know with a field like this. Or do you? Because that is, to me, is spreading the slurry on it. So yeah, we're just going to spread the slurry on this field, and then drop this tanker off, and then go to the shop and pick up a major tanker, just because we want it. And then we can start spreading some slurry on our couple of our grass fields near the farm. But yeah, what a nice view. Right, we are. I've gone way. Start, I thought I was spreading the slurry properly, and I'm not, I'm going way off here. But it's getting the ground, and we aren't bothered. So this tractor was brought for butt raking. And then it was used, we were going to use it for. What was it now? Baling. So it's going to sit on the McHale baler for a couple of goes. But at the moment we are mowing them two fields down there. We've changed our mind. They were going to be hay. They're now going to be round bale silage. So then we can send them to the. To the BJ plant to be sold. As you can tell, I'm not very good at spreading slurry. I overlap it, if you can see, like it'll still spread. So, yeah, we're just going to stop that there, because I think something up with this pipe. Okay. So this is what our new tanker is for the farm. So it's we would have got one of them, but our tractors, we have a lot of tractors. That isn't big enough for us. So we're just putting a worker on slurrying that ground for us. So what are we gonna do today? I had a couple of jobs to do today and I've totally forgot what I'm doing. Ah, this is what we were doing. So we've just power harrowed this, ready to be drilled. So these three fields here are going to be drilled with wheat again. So these are going to be our wheat fields. We have two fast tracks. One is mine, and then one is the farm manager's. This one is mine. And the farm manager one is the one. He's been carting straw from other farms, by other people who are selling straw. So he's been using his to cart. Got the new crone baler over there, which we're going to be doing a thingy on, a video on, straight after this one. So I tried to do the NHS in this field and it totally messed up. The N was bigger than the H. The H was thingy and the S wasn't even an S. So we're going to try and do it again at some point, but with this it's... So that's why there's like its ploughing bit isn't. So this now won't need ploughing for another three harvests. We try and plough them every three harvests. So this will now be direct drilled. I think you can still see, if you look there, the N, the H, half the H, and then the S would have been here, but the S isn't an S. So we're just plodding along with the, well, this is another piece of equipment, a power harrow. That we have purchased just because, well, we've needed one. So that's going to be done. We've changed the crone to a class now, a 980, and then we've brought a John Deere 9900i. I know people are going to comment and say, why has it got a New Holland header on it? When we brought it off the farmer, he was running it with a New Holland header, because all the other headers he's had with it weren't going right. So he's running it with a New Holland header. We're going to run it with a New Holland header this year, and see what we think of it. The plough is being moved. These are going to be sorted because they keep just doing different bits in the tight yard. What else? Oh yeah, the combine. We've sold the Massey. We are keeping two combines, but we've sold the Massey, and we've brought a smaller, a Tucken, 580. So both of them are now class. Our combines are class. But yeah, we're not doing too bad at the moment. We've got a job over at the place across the road. Is the thing in here? Yes. Please tell me it's got a bucket on it. No. I knew that we should have had two buckets for these. We'll use a muck grab. The muck grab should technically be on the loader, where it's doing the muck carting, muck pushing up, but we'll use it on this today, just because. It's easier going on this than. So yeah, we've got a lot of different machines down here. We've now got a fuel bowser. Got some straw pallets here, so I'm just going to stick some straw in. And no, it doesn't even work. So what we've done is we've sold, well, we've got a new bucket. Eggs are going for a decent price, and I've got loads, so I might sell them at that. Yeah, we'll take the eggs down next, which is down there. So we've got two of them now, the JCBs. Would like a JCB handler, but at the moment we're running fine with these two. So every morning I get, well, get up, I run the game, I wake up at like the house, usually get up about 6 o'clock, go down to the dairy, scrape up, bed up, feed them, check everything's alright because they've been milked. They usually get milked as I'm scraping up, and then they go out now. They go out now, so we're not too bad of scraping up, but it does get to the point if like I've been away for 3 days and I come back and you've got like a mound of thingy, then we have to get the big loader in. So what we do is we just pile this in here. So I'll show you, it goes in there, it then goes all the way up here, drops into an auger, then fills the pallets up, so it'll then fill it up in them. Then they go up into the pallet machine there, where they're being pushed at the moment. Yeah, I can come in here. So yeah, they get stacked into, is it them, like that. So then they will then get stacked. So yeah, we're just, let's put all the pallets in here, because then we've got some hay ones coming soon, which will then go into this one. And what we do is then we sell them. Just to make money at the end of the day. And then they get wrapped, and then there's the straw. So then we have a skid steer. New Holland skid steer, which then we use it on the bucket, on the part times. Then we sell them to there. So for hay, it's £44.95 per 20 gram kg. But straw is not good. So what we're going to do is, I think we're going to make more hay bales. Oh, the tanker's back. All right, we've got two now. Brilliant. So we've got to tip the vulture now with the hay pallets in. Back in just a second. And I'm back. Sorry about that. So yeah, we're just going to move these. Out of the yard, out of the pit for the moment. Pardon me. So what I'm doing is I'm just pushing the back to spin it around. And then I'm gonna hook this up to fill it up with some slurry from our pit, and then I've got an opportunity to use this today, but we'll be doing it off screen. It's for a customer of ours. They have a mate. They've just harvested some of the maize, and we, because our slurry tank at the moment is full. Well, not full, but fullish. We are supplying them with the slurry. So, and they don't like us videoing. So yeah, we're going to fill this up, take this over, spread it for them, and yeah, we'll probably scrape up, actually we'll get some scraping up done, because it's a bit of a, so if we keep on top of it, like once it gets to a pile where we can't push, then we have to get the loader in, but at the moment we're just scraping. So yeah, thank you for watching, please like and subscribe, and until next time, bye for now.